Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My beloved one, today is 7th day of March, being Tuesday, week 2 of Lent, year A. Today, the Monday Church remembers Saint Perpetua and Felicity, the matters of the church. Our readings will be coming from Prophet Isaiah chapter 1, verse 10, verse 16 to 20. Our response to Psalm will come from Psalm 50, verse 23 BC. Our gospel message will come from Matthew Gospel, chapter 23, verse 1 to 12. The theme of our message today, anyone who is greatest among you shall be your servant. You see, Jesus talking about it. Any person who claims to be greatest among you must be your, shall be your servant. You come to serve a humble and simple, humble somebody who have come to think about the people, to serve the people. He's ready to keep hungry that they will eat. He's ready to go naked that they are clothed. He's ready to have sleepless nights so that they will sleep. He's ready to lower down himself to lift them up. He's ready to become a cause for them to be blessed. That's the servant. That's the greatest among us. And Jesus was making them to know today. That any person want to be greatest among you must be yourself servant of all. That is the difference what we have in Nigeria. People want to be greatest in Nigeria, want to be slave every person. They want to slave every person that have been their method, have been the modus for the past 60 years. They just enslave the people, dehumanize them, exploit them, deny them, and kill them. And not serving them, and eating, exploiting the people. And that's why they say, well, we are saying they should go. They should go. They have had that enough of us. I got enough of powder fresh from all of us. They should go. So to somebody tell us that they should continue with Tinubu being declared elected is madness. It's unacceptable in the year 2023. And one of the international letter will put it that the greatest drug pusher has turned out the one election in Nigeria, one of the greatest countries in Africa. A druggist, a billionaire druggist, has won election. How can a druggist won election in Nigeria? And the government, although a criminal government begets criminality and criminal representations. Now why it was all criminality in the last election. And that's why any person who wants to be servant of others must be their greatest person. I will sometimes address them as your excellency because he's the servant of all. That's why Jesus began to tell the crowd and his disciples, get it right. Scribes and the Pharisees sit on the Moses' seat. So practice and observe whatever they teach you, but don't practice what they do because they don't practice what they preach. I challenge to many pastors today. What you are preaching is not what you are practicing. Your mouth is one side and your action is another side. And what the true evangelization is witnessing for what you are preaching. As evangelical guide, we say so. Evangelist Sandy, Paul, she say, it is witnessing that is truly evangelization. Living out the word. But these people don't live out the word. What they are there for sure. They dress abnormally to attract abnormal attentions. They want to be saluted in big places, the marketplaces. They want to take a place of honor in every occasion. That's what they want. And they want to be called rabbi. You say you should not be called rabbi. I have only one rabbi. Don't call yourself rabbi. You have only one rabbi. And that's the teacher. And you are all brethren. We are all brethren. You can't begin to arrogate to yourself what you are not. We are all brethren. We are brothers and sisters. And call no man your father on earth, you have only one father in heaven. Call no person master, you have only one master, Lord Jesus Christ. And now I say, who is greatest among you shall be your servants. Anyone who exalts himself will be humbled. Anyone who humbles himself will be exalted. We shall experience it this year in this election that has not been manipulated. We see how it will end. All those who exalted themselves in this election will be humbled. And now why you can see people who practice what they, who say what they don't practice, are conceited minds, hypocrites, double-faced human beings. They say yes, it means no. They say come, means go. And that's why Jesus is making them, the only way you can remain a servant of others by being more obedient to the word of God. That's why he say, hear the word of the Lord, use rulers of Sodom. Give ears to the teaching of our God, you people of Gomorrah. Watch yourself. Make yourself clean. Remove the evil of your doing from before my eyes. Cease to do evil. That's the only way you can be a greatest among others, not to do evil. Learn to do good. Seek justice. Correct oppression. You see, when you are the one oppressing the people, you are the one promoting injustice, you are the one doing evil, how can you say you are a leader of the people? Defend the fatherless, rather you are oppressing the fatherless. Pray for widows, when you are the one killing widows and raping them and their children. Come now and let us reason together. When you have done this, when you have humbled yourself and served others, when you have become a servant to others, come to me. Let's reason together. If your sins have been as scarlet, they shall be white as snow. Though they are red as crimson, they shall become like a wool. You see, God telling you that if you leave this evil path and come back to him, you will be good. Everything will be changed. If you are willing and obedient, if you are willing, get it right, if you are willing and obedient, yes, if you are willing, have the strength to be willing to do the will of God and be obedient to the word of God, you say you shall. You say, you shall eat the good of the land. But if you refuse and rebel, you shall be devoured by the sword. It's simple. Yes. If you exalt yourself, you'll be humbled. If you humble yourself, you'll be exalted. So if you keep to the word of God, be obedient, willing to be obedient to God, we'll eat the good fruits of the land. But otherwise, you'll perish. And that's why the psalmist who understood this message so well, they say, to one whose way is blameless, I will show the salvation of God. To the one whose way is blameless, what the way to be blameless is to obey the word of God and live out the word of God. Not preaching it in the mouth without doing it, but living out the word as the way your life will be blameless. And God will show you the salvation of God. And that's why today we are celebrating some Perpetua and Felicitas. Perpetua was a nobleman of 22 years old. Has a slave girl called Felicity, was pregnant at the time. It was a persecution by Septimus Severus in Carthage in the year 203. And was killing many, daily century, killing people for their faith. And this noble lady and her slave were hand in hand, devoured by beasts and the sword. And they become a living example for people who will live out their faith without compromise. I'm challenging all of us who cannot, you can't live this faith in compromise. We are called to live out the faith. And the only way we can do that is to be a servant to all by keeping to the word of God. May God help us understand this message today. And we want to be great among our people, we must be the servants. And the only way to do it is to live out the word of God and be a servant to all. By being obedient to the word of God, who became obedient unto death. Jesus became obedient unto death. And because of that, the Father raised him above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee will bow, Every tongue will confess in heaven, on earth, and under the earth, to the glory of the Father. You can see in Philippians 2, 8 to 11. And now what we are talking about today, if you want to be greatest among your people, be your servant of all. Serve. The bread the people who oppress. Speak for the fatherless. Care for the widows. Leave evil, do good. Seek justice, not injustice. May God help us understand the message today through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May the blessings of Almighty God be upon all of us, and we aspire to be the greatest among the all by serving all the days of our life and being obedient to God, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you all. Yeah, yeah, no, yeah, yeah, no.